The South Dakota State football team opens the home portion of its 2022 schedule tomorrow night under the lights at Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium in a rematch of last year's opening round of the FCS playoffs as SDSU welcomes UC Davis in for the Dairy Drive. Hi friends, Tyler Merriam, and welcome to Gameday Eve. Before we begin, we want to remind you to subscribe to our Jackrabbit Sports Network podcast. Hours of great content each week, including comments from all the various coaches in season. Now, the SDSU football team, ranked number 2 in the FCS, opened the year at Iowa. And what a contest it was. There were certainly a lot of positives in this one and a few things the Jacks would like to improve upon offensively. Let's start with some of the positive numbers. SDSU held Iowa to 166 total yards. In the 15-plus years the Jacks have been Division I, that's the fifth fewest against any Division I team, and it came against an FBS team that won the Big Ten West a year ago. The Jacks limited the Hawkeyes to just 1.6 yards per rush and forced a pair of turnovers. And how good were the Jackrabbits defensively? Try this on for size. Veteran quarterback Spencer Petras on third downs was 1 for 10. The only completion was for 8 yards. It wasn't for a first down. He was sacked once and threw a pick. So when Iowa attempted a pass on third down, it did not convert. What a statement about that defense coordinated by Jimmy Rogers. Adam Bach had 13 tackles in the game. Sensational performance for the hometown kid. And that amazing strip in mid-motion and coming up with the football to turn Iowa back inside the Jackrabbit 10. And how about the performance of Hunter Dustman? He made his second career field goal in yellow and blue. 11 punts, a 41.5-yard average after a rocky start. Dustman was very, very good in Iowa City. On the negative side, the Jackrabbits allowed 2 safeties in that game. And try this on for size. SDSU has not played a football game in which there were multiple safeties within that game dating back to the 1950s. That's how rare what happened last Saturday was. Offensively, SDSU's biggest issue was field position. Jacks ran 57 plays. 16 of them were inside their own 10. 25 of the 57 snaps the SDSU offense had inside of its own 15-yard line. That makes for tough sledding, and then penalties a huge issue. Jacks committed 12 for 66. 8 of those were false starts. So some things to improve upon going into Saturday. Now this, as I mentioned before, will be a rematch of last year's opening round playoff tilt here in Brookings. The Jacks won decisively 56-24, trailed 10-7 in the second quarter, then turned it on. And it was a combination of defense and the running game. SDSU established a new school record with 6 interceptions, returning 2 of them for touchdowns. And Dallas Beanham, what a day the young man had at corner, intercepting 3 UC Davis passes. On the offensive side of the ball, SDSU established a new playoff program record, 446 rushing yards in the contest. Isaiah Davis went for 217, Pierre Strawn Jr. for 185. Let's talk a little about this UC Davis team. A year ago, 8-1, top 10 in the FCS, and then suffered back-to-back blowout losses at home, and then came out to Brookings, decimated in the playoffs. Those 3 defeats to end the regular season by a combined total of 70 points. Led by a veteran head coach, Dan Hawkins, in year 6 at Davis. Previous stops include Boise State and Colorado. He was also a head coach in the CFL. This Davis team, wide open and very explosive offensively. They can hurt you in a variety of ways, but it all starts with Ulonzo Gilliam, number 34, the exceptional running back and All-American, the preseason Big Sky Offensive Player of the Year. He is Davis's all-time leading rusher. He's also 7th in school history in career receptions. And to that point, last week in their season opening loss against Pac-12 opponent Cal, 14 rushes, 115 yards and a score, and he also caught a team-high 7 passes. Davis's quarterback, Miles Hastings, number 7, one of 2 men who played quarterback in the majority of that playoff game last year. He's the guy, very smart young man, threw for 242 in the loss at Cal. They really like what Hastings can do. Other individual you want to keep your eye on, you'll see him in a variety of roles, number 18, Trent Tompkins. His nickname is Magic because it seems like every time he touches the football, magic happens, is what the folks at Davis say. He will be used as a quarterback at times. They will run the football with him. They'll throw the ball to him. He'll return kicks. He is something else. And a preseason All-American at tight end, McAllen Castles, number 87, a transfer from Cal. Big load to bring down. He's a weapon, 6'5", 233. Now, defensively, that was one of Davis's negatives of a year ago. Gave up almost 430 yards per game. Very talented linebacker, number 15, Teddy Buchanan, had 8 stops last week and an interception, the leading tackler during the 2021 campaign for the Aggies. Number 14, Chris Venable, the second leading tackler from a year ago, made his 24th start last week, and he's the second leading tackler, as I mentioned, from a season ago. Now, UC Davis, very different in the special teams game. Daniel Whelan, the punter last year, led the nation in yards per punt. He's graduated. Davis used 2 different punters last week with a combined average of 39 per kick and also missed both a PAT and a field goal in that game at Cal. One other number to keep an eye on is 3. That's the number on the jersey of Lan Larrison, one of the best returners, punts and kicks in all of Division I college football. Jacks have to be prepared to defend that as well. This is the Dairy Drive on Saturday night at Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium. A few tickets are still available for tomorrow's home opener at jackrabbittickets.com. We have a 2-hour radio pregame throughout the Jackrabbit Sports Network. If you come to the stadium, listen on 98.1 inside the stadium, but our friends at 570 WNAX and the rest of the network will have it. The Jackrabbit app, the Varsity Network app, or Midcoast Sports will televise the contest. Our radio coverage starts at 4. Video coverage starts at 6, the Jackrabbit All Access, ESPN Plus, Midco Sports Plus, etc. SDSU hosting UC Davis. It's the Dairy Drive to kick off the home portion of the 2022 football campaign.